In this video from ITFreeTraining, I will look at the exam objective, Deny Domain Local Group. This exam objective is difficult to find information on, but essentially, it is a few group policy settings that can deny users or groups access to particular rights on a computer. A right on a computer essentially allows a user to do something. For example, some of the rights include logging on locally, accessing the computer from the network, and accessing the computer using remote desktop. These can be configured on the local computer by a local administrator or using domain group policy. In some cases, a network administrator may want to remove access for a user or group. This may be because of security reasons. For example, in a secure environment, you may want to prevent the computer from being accessed from remote via the network. Using Deny Local Group, you can remove the rights from users of that computer regardless of what settings have been configured beforehand. These settings can be found in the following group policy location. There are 5 settings which can be configured. To have a better look at these settings, I will open Group Policy Management and then edit the default domain policy. I will next navigate down through Group Policy until I get to User Rights Assignment. Normally, when you assign rights to users, you would use a setting like Allow Logon through Remote Desktop Services. If I open this setting, normally you would define the settings and then add the required users and groups that you wanted to use at the bottom. The problem with this approach is the settings will replace whatever was previously configured. If you only want to deny a user or group access, you would need to enter in all the users and groups required minus the ones not required. This requires the administrator to have knowledge of which users and groups have already been configured. If I exit out of here and go down to the Deny settings, these options can be used to effectively remove access to a user or group without requiring any knowledge of what permissions have already been applied. You can see the 5 settings that can be configured. The first is Deny Access to this computer from the network. This will prevent the user or group from accessing the computer using the network. However, this does not prevent access to the computer using remote desktop. The next setting is Deny Logon as Batch Job. This refers to jobs that are running using the task scheduler that are not interactive. Interactive means that it does not require access to the desktop. If this is enabled, jobs that are attempted to be run using the task scheduler as the user will be denied. The next setting, Deny Logon as a Service, prevents that user or group from being used to run a service on the computer. The next setting, Deny Logon Locally, prevents the user from logging in locally to the computer. Locally essentially means that the user is physically at the computer attempting to log in rather than accessing it from remote. The last setting is Deny Logon through Remote Desktop Services. This setting will prevent access to the computer using remote desktop. If I open Deny Logon through Remote Desktop Services, to configure it is a simple matter of ticking Define These Policy Settings and then adding the required users and groups. In this case, I will add domain users, which will prevent any user in the domain users group from using remote desktop to access the computer. Essentially, I have removed access for the domain users group without knowing the permissions that were already applied. You can see that using the Deny setting can make administration easier. However, you should also consider who is in the group and make sure that you are denying the people you required. This is the last video of the group policy videos, all part of the free Active Directory course. If you want to see more from this course and others, why not consider subscribing? Thanks, and see you next time.